Hey everyone, Jess here. So in the first video of this series, we established we are working in UE 5.2.1 and FMOD 2.02.15. We've downloaded the free Cropout Sample Project and integrated FMOD in the project. Now let's take a look at the game. We appear to be building a community on an island, so let's start with ambience. I see the ocean and the trees blowing, so we will add some waves and wind ambience. In FMOD, I'm going to create an environment folder and then create an event named Island Amb. I'm adding my timeline sheet and track and then dragging in an ambient sound I've already got made. Right click up here to make a looping region so that it will continuously play once started. And then right click the master volume control to add ASDR so that it will fade in and out when the event starts or stops. Make sure on the master it's only set to one instance. Since this is an ambience, I don't want this event playing more than once at the same time, so setting this prevents that from accidentally happening. Assign the event to the master bank, and then we're going to go ahead and save and build our banks. Now let's go back to the project and see where we can put this. Usually in ambience, you could just go ahead and open the level blueprint and see how that works out for you. We're just going to find where we would like to put this. So you see the event begin play node, and then it looks like there's some nodes to play the music. And so after that, let's go ahead and add an event play event at 2D node, and we'll select our Island Amb event. And so you then compile and save, and once we play, it should automatically start. And we're hearing the ambience, so that's good. Let's take a look and see what else is here. I'm seeing these birds here, and so I want to pause and check that out. It's not selecting them when I click them, but I see here in the outliner that there are birds flying. There's a birds flying actor, and it appears to be Niagara system, which is similar to the particle system in Unity from what I understand. So it just kind of creates like random visual effects. So we're going to add a seagulls event to represent this. I've already made assets for this as well, and I'm going to drag them in together to create a multi-instrument, and so it will just randomly play one of these three audio files when started. I'm adding some randomization to the pitch and the start offset just to make this sound a little more natural. So once we save and build that, we're going to go back into Unreal and we're going to add an FMOD audio component to this bird flying actor. And in the dropdown, we will select our seagulls event and hit play, and let's see what happens. And so we hear the seagulls. It just plays once. It's a bit loud. So there's some things we can tweak here. Let's go ahead and add a spatializer to make it 3D. I'd like to add a looping region just to where it won't play just once. It'll continue hitting that track. I'm going to lower the probability, that way it doesn't play a sound every time it loops. So now I'm not really hearing it. Probably since we add the spatializer, it's something to do with the distance settings. So we're going to go back and check that. We're just going to make that a little larger and see what happens. See if we can hear them after that. And we're still not hearing them, and so let's go back to FMOD, and we can do a live update. Let's connect that. You do that while Unreal Engine is running. And now we can make the adjustments and we can hear our changes as we make them. So now we're hearing the birds and they're sound getting a little better. We see that as we zoom in and out, the distance from the camera affects how we are hearing the birds. And so maybe we would like the ocean ambience to do the same thing. And so I'm going to remove that from the blueprint. We're going to just disconnect that play event 2D node in the main level blueprint. Instead, we're going to find the island actor and we'll add a FMOD component to that. And just like we did with the seagulls, and we'll now need to add a spatializer and set our distance the same way. So everything seems to be working as expected. We just might want to adjust the distances, the volume, just minor tweaks at this point. Our ocean sounds a little aggressive, so that might be something we want to change later. And then also, as we start filling in the sounds of our little characters and things like that, we might bring these ambiences down a little too. On the spatializer, I'm going to change the envelopment setting from auto to user. That way, it won't be so centralized to one location. In this case, I'm going to max out the sound size and the minimum extent. That way, I can make sure it sounds like it's all around you and not just in the middle of the map. Oh, we ran out of food. Okay, play again, and we see everything starts back like it should. Thank you for watching, and in the next video, we'll start looking into how to add sounds to these little characters.